steel and timber composite of method of building has been one of the ways in minimizing the high costs of building in Uganda. In the other hand, the law enforcers say that this is not the best method to use here in our country. In this regard, the Uganda Builders Review Board came up with an abolition of the steel timber composite method of building. Today, in the Homes and Construction Affairs show, we need to learn and understand what prompted them in abolishing this method of building. My name is Hilda Kamkama. Join me and we learn together. For starters, why did you advise the minister to prohibit the steel timber concrete composite method of building?
Thank you so much, Hilda and Urban TV, for giving us the opportunity to speak to you and also to shed some light on what is happening in the building sector. First of all, STC is a name that was patented by one of the clever Ugandans, I would say, who brought this building method in Uganda. But this method in full is known as the steel timber concrete composite building method. And you asked me a question, why did we advise the minister to prohibit this building method? Hilda, I will tell you is that in 2020, NBRB commissioned a study. And this study was as a result of several complaints and also several cases of building accidents that we had investigated. And one of the causes of these building accidents was to do with this new method of construction that had come into our market. So we commissioned a study in 2020 to find out what exactly is with this method. For those who don't know this method, to explain it to describe it in the layman's language, is this is where steel is joined with timber to form the slab. It is upon the steel and timber that is welded where someone puts concrete or the slab, and they plaster it, they cover it. And sometimes they go on to construct other floors, or in some cases, they stop there and paint it. So after doing this investigation, we came to a conclusion that one, this method had some barriers that were making it unsafe and a risk to the developers and also to the public. One, we found out that we do not have adequate skilled manpower in terms of the professionals to design and also implement this building method. Those who are doing it were just gambling with it. Secondly, we found out that the materials, for example, timber, we did not have the right specifications, and we don't know as of now, how does this timber bond with steel? How do you use it? And also we found out that even those that were implementing this method, when they went to the building committees in the urban and local authorities, their drawings, structure, mechanical, civil, architectural drawings, were all for the convention, for the old building method we know. So we found out that even the approvals were wrong. So we are null and void, so we are illegal. So in that, we advised the minister that for now, let's prohibit this method until we carry out more further studies, we develop guidelines on how this method can be implemented for the safety of our built environment.
How can one differentiate the building that used STC from the one that used the conventional way of building that you have been knowing?
Differentiation can be, as I've told you, in terms of the materials they use. As I told you, this new method, someone uses steel, they join it with timber, they form the slab, they plaster it, and maybe put on more floors or stop there. But the building, the conventional building method, you all know how it's done. They use the mitaimbwa, sometimes they use the max spans, they put the concrete or the slab and they construct.
As NBRB, your mandate is to regulate, monitor and supervise the buildings here in Uganda. So the question is, where have you been all this while that these buildings have been erected and you come out now to say that you are going to put a ban on them?
We would not act from nowhere, from a vacuum. That's why I told you we had to first commission a study. That's almost 2 years ago, 2020, to study this method. Because prohibition does not come from space. You must base somewhere. You must have evidence that this method is not safe or it is safe before you can take action. So to ask me where we have been, my answer would be, we would not act from nowhere. We had to first study the method before we would recommend or advise the minister to either prohibit or leave it to exist.
Now the method has been abolished. What happens to the Ugandans that have been running away from the high cost of construction and building to find comfort and safety in the SDC? What is going to happen to them now?
Okay, first of all, there are two things we are confusing here. One is cost saving or cost cutting and safety. As regulators, our core responsibility is safety. It makes no sense for you to assume you're cutting costs. You erect a building, after 1 year, it falls down. Would you have saved costs? Would you have cut costs? No. What matters is safety. This is the argument we are having with some of the sector players. Should we prioritize reducing the cost of construction or the safety? That is a debate, but in our line of thinking, safety comes first. Now, to answer your question, in the circular that was after the legal notice that was issued by the minister, we released a press statement in which we offered some guidance. One, we said that after the prohibition, we already established a technical team that is going to further study this method and come up with guidelines on how it can be safely implemented. Secondly, we also directed the building committees, which we supervise, one, to carry out structural integrity assessments on all the structures that have been constructed using this method. After doing that assessment, they will furnish us with their reports. It is from those assessments that we will find out that if some of the structures constructed using this method can be retrofitted to meet the building control legal framework, that will be done. For those that will be found very difficult and hard to retrofit, they will be demolished in accordance with the law. So the building committees, on 14th this month, the Executive Secretary, Engineer Guto Flavia Wire, issued a circular directing the building committees to carry out this responsibility within a period of 6 months and report back to the board on the actions they would have taken.
Before the refitting of the buildings that you think may actually come out of the report, is it easy for one to know actually after finishing the construction of a certain building? Can one tell the method that was used for the building to be erected after the plastering and everything?
Simple. For a layman, it is very difficult to understand. Imagine you've gone to a shopping mall that has been constructed using this method. It has been painted. It all looks nice. For a layman, it might be hard to understand. But for a technical person, for a professional, they can easily identify these structures.
In the meantime, for the ones that have already used this method, what happens to the buildings?
The prohibition took immediate effect on 19th September. The moment the minister issued that legal notice, it is law. Those who were going on with the construction, they had to stop. Those that had finished construction, their buildings must be assessed technically by registered professionals to find out their integrity. As I've said, those that will be found to be fit or to be in a position of being retrofitted, that will be done in accordance with the law. And this must be done on the recommendation of a registered professional. And those that will be found to be in a position of not being able to be retrofitted, guidance will be given for these structures to be demolished in accordance with the law. Yes.
Now, the demolishing bit, is there any kind of compensation that the board has prepared for the people that actually may be affected by that act?
No. Compensation for what? If you're putting up an illegal structure, from the word go, as I've explained, these structures, any STC you've been seeing has been put up illegally. Why? Because, let me explain to you, because the structure, the drawings and the designs they took for approval are for the conventional method of construction.
Okay.
What, you see, this is the difference. One goes to a building committee, for example, in Wakiso, and they say, I want to construct a Class A building. What they take there are the ordinary drawings, designs, and what have you. But when they go on site, the implementation is different. So already, you've gone away from the approved plans. You've gone away from the building permit you were given, meaning that whatever you're putting up is illegal. So that is the baseline.
You want to tell me that the STC method of building has no plan? Like,
what I'm saying is that what the developers or the professionals who have been supervising this building method, what they have been using, the designs and the drawings, are for the old method. When they go down on ground for implementation, they implement STC. Meaning that there's a difference between the approvals and implementation.
Because this is what happens ideally. What we know that when you think of having your building, then you go through the processes where the BOQs are also involved. Now, does that mean that in the BOQs that we have been having, the one for steel and timber concrete composite has not been reflected?
Let's be honest and realistic to ourselves. There's a difference between approval and implementation. You can have all your drawings on paper, all your designs on paper, approved, stamped by the professionals, by the building committee. But when it reaches to implementation, you implement the opposite. Am I right or wrong?
Some do that, maybe.
Yes. So this is what has been happening with this method. Your approvals are different. What you're implementing is different. In most cases, we had one of the proponents of that method here. And he clearly admitted that there are designs that were approved are different from what they have been implementing.
Putting that aside, because we are going to come back on it, all I need is for our ordinary person, who has saved the money to erect an A-class building, gets justice or served to their satisfaction. now, as the review board, the National Builders Review Board, the 4 years you have been in existence, my worry comes here now on the fourth year. Eh? Okay, the other 2 years, yes, you were there, maybe observing them. Eh? Why didn't you then raise that red flag?
We couldn't raise the red flag before we conclude our investigations. We had to first study, as I've explained. This agency does not take decisions out of the blue. They are well studied, thought of, before any recommendations are made. So, for someone to think or to argue that we woke up one day, advised the minister, no, we did a report and we have case studies. And the report covered not only the Greater Kampala Metropolitan, but we went as far as Mbale. We also visited in Tungam. We visited some of the structures that were using this method. And we did a thorough investigation that we based on to advise the minister to prohibit the method. For any Ugandan out there, what is important if we want to improve this sector is safety. Believe me or not, if you put up a structure and you don't follow the right procedures, as day follows night, that structure will one day come down. And it is you, the developer, who will lose at the end of that day. It is the occupants, innocent occupants, who would have paid, who would have maybe come to visit a shopping mall, who will suffer when this building comes down. So meaning that it is your responsibility and my responsibility as a regulator to ensure that the built environment is safe for all of us, because if it is not safe, we're all going to lose at the end of that day. So we either ensure that we are safe now and in the future, which we must do as a National Building Review Board, or we all perish, and we can't perish. We must do something.
Do you think, in your own understanding, that steel timber composite method of building has something good or an advantage?
The advantage people have been fronting is that it cuts costs. But I've told you that before you look at reducing the costs, look at safety first. For example, you might want to put up a structure and you say, I want to cut costs. A professional has told me to use 10 bags of cement. Let me use 6. They've told me to use Y20 steel. You can choose to use 12. Isn't it?
Yes.
You're cutting costs. But at the end of that day, the structure will come down. Because it is not strong enough maybe to support the weight or the strength, the weight you've given it. So what matters most is safety.
So maybe
another thing I need to clarify. Some people have also been arguing that this method is being used somewhere else. It is being used in Dubai, it is being used in Germany, in UK. Yes, it is. But UK is not Germany. I mean, UK is not Uganda. Why? They are professionals. And not the ones we have here. We have them. That's not what we are saying as the board. The materials they are using, are they of the same specifications like the materials we are using? We are not against innovation. We are not drilling innovation. But what we are saying is that this method, if it is to be implemented here, it should be implemented within our environment. Let's first study it. Let's develop guidelines. Why the rush? Let's develop the guidelines. We understand that. For example, you're talking about timber. Do you know which timber they are using? Where does it come from?
We have
How old is it?
We have our forest.
What is the size of it? After some time, how does this timber bond with steel?
React with the steel.
How does it? We don't know all these things. Even the professionals are just studying, are also learning. So we don't want people to implement something they do not fully understand. Let's first study it. Let's develop guidelines. For the safety of the sector, we are not against innovation. We are not against people cutting costs. But what we are saying, the method should be safe.
If you are to recommend, where do you think the STC can be favorable applied?
For now?
Yes.
As the board, our position is, let's first study. Let us first come up with the guidelines before we can talk of implementing this method anywhere in the country.
You talked about the safety of our buildings and the lives of our people. Over time, we've had issues of collapsing buildings. Even way back before, this method was introduced here in Uganda. My question is, do you think that is the reason, as I have read, do you think that that point that you're clinging onto is real, is the actual reason of the collapsing buildings that we are having here in the nation?
Ask you a simple question. If they take you to a hospital and you have a headache, and later they find out that you have a wound on your leg, do you think the hospital does not treat the wound because they took you to the hospital for headache? The hospital treats everything. So, there are many other causes of building accidents, as I'm going to explain. But STC is one of them. So, we should also deal with it. Two wrongs do not make one right. There are many causes of accidents. One is to do with the standard of the building materials. Some building materials have been duplicated. They are of substandard. And what we are doing as the board, we are working with the Uganda National Housing Construction Company. We've secured land in Lubowa where we are going to construct the building materials laboratory, Building Materials Quality Assurance Center, NBRC. It is at this center that we are going to test the building materials. Right now, the testing is done by UNBS. We also have a laboratory under the Ministry of Works, but we want, as the regulators of this sector, to have our own laboratory that will ensure that we do quick, fast, and reliable tests. In March, we signed a memorandum of understanding with National Housing. In May, the Minister for Works, that is General Katumba Wamala, broke the ground for the construction, and we are on course. That is one cause of building accidents, and the solution we are trying to find.